Hey everybody, and welcome back to another Python scripting tutorial. So in this video, we're going to be creating a new add-on called the text tool add-on, and you can see the example here. So the first thing we can do is go ahead and load up our scripting layout. If you have one, go ahead and load it up. If you don't have one, just scroll through here and find the scripting workspace. Then I'm just going to go through here and tidy a few things up. So we don't need these two windows, I'm going to right click and join the area. Same thing for this one. We can keep this window since we're going to be using it a little bit later on, so for now I'm just going to minimize this. Also while we're here, I'm just going to enable the word wrap. And then I'm also going to minimize the Python console. And then for this window, I'm going to press A to select everything. Then I'm going to press X and just delete these since we don't need them. So the idea for this, we're going to add a panel to the window here, though similar to this object adder. We're going to press a button, which will then bring up a pop-up menu like this, where we can enter some text, and then we can add things like the scale, maybe the alignment, and a few other things like you would have seen in the example. So that's the idea. So the first thing we need to do is create this panel. But before we do that, we're going to need the BL information. So let's go ahead and just create a new script. So I'm going to call this the text tool. And then for the extension, we want to save this as a .py. And then before we do anything else, let's go over to text and save as. So now, as I mentioned, we need to add the BL info, and we've done this in a previous video. So if you want to check out any of the previous videos, there'll be a link up here to the playlist. But instead of typing everything out, we can just go to templates, then to Python. And we want to choose the add-on add object. So select this. And the first thing we can see is this BL information here. So I'm going to select all of this all the way down to this brace. Then I'm going to copy it. Then we might as well unlink this. Then I'm going to paste this in here, and there we go. So now we can go through this and change all the relevant information. So then after this brace, I'm just going to hit enter a few times. Then we can import the Blender Python, import BPY. Now we need to create a panel just as we did for the object adder or for the shader library. So we're going to add a panel here. And again, if you followed the previous tutorials, you already know how to do that, but we can go to templates, to Python, scroll through here and find UI panel simple, open this up, and then we can copy this class. In fact, we can copy it all the way down and copy this registration as well. So I'm going to copy this. Again, we can unlink this and then paste this in. So this is our panel. Let's first change the class name. Let's change it to something more appropriate, and this would be object underscore PT underscore, I'm going to call this text tool. Then since we've changed this name here, we need to copy this. And if we scroll down, we just need to paste this in here since we changed the name. There we go. Then back up here, we don't need a tooltip. We can get rid of this. So the label refers to the name on the panel. Let's change this. Now the ID name can stay the same. If you want, you can change it, it's up to you. Then for the space type, well, we don't want it in the properties over here, we want it in the 3D view. So this is going to be in capitals, view underscore 3D. Then the region type is going to be UI. And then the last one is no longer context, so I'm just going to delete this, it's actually category. And then I'm going to get rid of this, and then apostrophe twice, and then in between here I'm going to type the name of our new tab. So it's going to be down here, some new name. So let's call this the text tool. Then inside the panel we have a whole bunch of stuff that we actually don't need. So if we select all of this here and just delete it, the only thing we want to keep is this layout equals self.layout. keep the row equals layout.row and the row.operator. So this is all we need for the panel. It's just a simple button, which is going to add a cube. So if we go over here now and run script, we can see we've added a new tab called text tool. If we move this down a bit, you'll be able to read it. There we go. And we can see within this panel, which says text tool, it's just going to add a cube, which is very simple. Now we don't want it to add a cube. We want it to do something different. We want to press a button that brings up a dialog box. So we're going to get rid of this here. And then if we run script, the button now disappears. So we need to create that operator or that pop-up dialog box, which again, it's pretty simple. We did this in the last scripting tutorial. So if you want to check it out, go ahead and click that link. And yeah, it will show you how to create a dialog box. In this video, we're going to do the same thing, but maybe a little bit different since we're going to be using a Boolean. So let's go ahead and create that operator. I'm going to go to the beginning of a new line. Just add some space here like this. So I'm going to type class WM for window manager, underscore OT for operator type, underscore text op, and then open and close parentheses, add a colon. And then in between the parentheses, it's just like a normal operator. So it's going to be BPY dot types dot operator. And then this also needs a label and an ID name. So I'm going to go up here and just copy this. And then go down here and just paste this in. Now the label is going to refer to the name on top of the dialog box. So let's call this the text tool operator. And then the ID name, let's change this completely. We're going to change this to wm.textop. And this is what's going to be used to call the operator. So we can copy this and paste it in here. So the next thing we need to do is add some properties that will be displayed when we launch the dialog box. Text equals bpy.props.stringProperty. Then open and close parentheses, and inside here we can define a few parameters such as the name. So here I'm going to type enter text. The next thing I'm going to add is maybe the scale. So scale equals bpy.props.floatProperty. And in the last video I used a float vector, so we could have three different values to change, but this is going to be more of a uniform scale. So open and close parentheses. Again, we can define the name. And then for this one, we do need to define the default because we want to make sure that the default is always going to be at least one. And again, the user can change what the scale will be, but by default, we want it to make sure it's a value of one. So I will come back and add some properties in a second, but for now, let's just move on. So now we can define what's going to be executed when the button is pressed. So I'm going to type def execute. Open and close parentheses, add a colon. Then in between here, I'm going to type self, comma, context. And then hit enter, and I'm going to type return. Open and close brace. Then in between here, I'm going to hit apostrophe twice. Then in between here, in capitals, I'm going to type finished. So anything that's placed in between here will be executed when the button is pressed. Then after this, we need to define the invoke method. So def invoke, open and close parentheses, add a colon. Then in between here, we want to type self, comma, context, comma, event. And then hit enter, and then we can return. And then we can type context dot window underscore manager dot invoke underscore props underscore dialog. Open and close parentheses, and in between here I'm just going to type self, and then that's it. So we just need to register this class. I'm going to copy this, let's go down here to the register and unregister, and I'm just going to paste this in here for now, and then copy this one, paste this in, and then paste this one, copy this, and just replace this one here like that, and then we don't need this now. So now when we run script, we'll have a button, and then when we press it, it brings up a dialog box. I mean, it's not really connected to anything right now, and when we press OK, nothing happens. So let's go ahead and do that. So as I mentioned, anything we place in between here will be executed when this button is pressed. So as we saw in the example, I want some text to be added. So if we shift A, text, add some text in. We can see down here in the information, we have the code. So I'm going to select this and copy it. Then in between here, I'm just going to paste this in. Then if we delete the text, run the script just to update everything. Then if we press the button again, then this time when we press OK, we should add some text. And it does. So it works. That's good. I'm going to delete that. So that works all well and good, but now we want to connect this up so when we type some words in here, it actually changes the text to whatever we type in. So that's pretty simple to do. Again, I'm going to delete this. So to do that, we first need to go into edit mode because the context will change. We can see right now it's using an object, but in a second it's going to be font. So what we can do here where it says enter underscore edit mode equals false, well, we can actually change this to be true. So now if we run script, open the dialog box and then hit OK. Now we can see it adds text, but we're actually inside edit mode. So the next thing we want to do is start to delete this text. So if we hit delete, we can see down here the code is bpy.ops.font.delete. So I'm going to select this and copy it. So then after we've added the text and then gone into edit mode, we're going to go down here and paste this in. And we can see, as I mentioned, it's changed context from object now to font because we're inside of edit mode. So inside the font, we're going to delete whatever type that we set. So right now by default, it's using previous or selection. So it's only going to delete the previous letter. What we can actually do if we delete this and then change this to previous underscore word, it will actually delete the whole word rather than just one letter. So now if we hit run script, I'm just going to go out of edit mode and then delete this and press this button again. Then press OK. Now we can see we've got a blank font that we can start to type words. This is not very helpful until we've finished everything, so let's continue. So now we have this where it's empty. The next thing we're going to do is add the words. So let's go down here, bpy.ops.font.text_insert. Then open and close parentheses, and inside here we can define what text is going to be added. So text equals, we just want to use this string property here. So again, if you've watched the previous video, you know we first need to reference this. So I'm going to go here and type t equals self.text. And then down here, text equals t. So now if we hit run script, then click this button and then type some custom words. Hit OK. And there we go. Now we have some custom words. But you can see we're still in edit mode, so we need to just finish this off by closing it up like that. And if we press tab, we can see the code down here. So I'm just going to select this, copy it. Then after this text, I'm just going to paste this in. And then if we click this button, it'll bring up the dialog box. And by the way, we can see it says here the name text tool operator, which is referring to this label here. But we can see the button also says text tool operator, which it doesn't look too good. Let's go back up here to the panel, then here where it says row.operator, after this quotation I'm going to add a comma, and then if we type text equals and then type some text, for example type add text, then if we hit run script we can see it now says add text, and we can also add an icon if we want. So again, add a comma, type icon equals, then apostrophe twice, and then in between here just type the name of the icon that you want to use. So I did mention I want to add a boolean, so let's go ahead and add a boolean property here, and this is going to be for the alignment. So I'm going to call this center equals bpy.props.boolProperty, and then open and close parentheses. Then inside here I'm going to define the name. So center origin, then add a comma, and we also want to set the default, and we want to set this to false. So now we've created a boolean, we need to make sure we reference it. I'm also going to reference the scale as well, so s equals self.scale and c equals self.center. So as we can see right now, by default, the way Blender aligns the origin point is here at the bottom left. So when we do things like rotate it and create animations like that, it's rotating from this point here. But sometimes it's good to rotate it from the center. So if we, for example, if we moved it over here like this and rotated it from the center, it would give us a different kind of look. So I'm going to add this now, go to a new line, and we're going to use an if statement. If C, which is referring to this, which is referring to the Boolean. So if the Boolean is equal to, so we add two equal signs. If it's equal to true, then add a colon. Then we want something to happen. And what do we want to happen? Well, if we just open up this menu here, make sure we have some text selected, then we can go to the font tab. And again, we can use a whole bunch of these different things to change or add to our panel or add to our dialog box. Again, it's entirely up to you. But for this example, I'm probably going to add the geometry, so the extrude value. I'll do that in a second. But now if we go to paragraph, then down to alignment, then we can see here we have the horizontal and vertical. So right now it's left and top base. If I select this and change this to the center, select this one and change it to the center. Now we can see the origin has been centered. And also down here, we have the code that we need. So I'm just gonna minimize this and then first select this one, copy it, and then down here, paste this in. And then select the next one, copy it. Again, just add this in here. So now when we run script and we click this button, we can see we have the Boolean here. So first, let's say not center, and then click OK. Move these out of the way. Then let's add some more text, and let's just call this center, or centered, whichever you want. And then click this center the origin, and then click OK, and now we can see the origin has been centered. It's good for when we're creating animations or some sort of like font effects or things like that. So I'm not sure how often you'll use that, but it's there. And again, we can add a whole bunch of things that we have over here. Let's do the extrusion. So again, we need to create a property for that extrusion. I can copy this one here, this Boolean property. So I'm going to copy this and paste it in. First, we need to rename this to extrude. Then all this can stay the same. Let's change this name. Then down here, let's create a reference. And then here, I'm just going to type E equals self.extrude. And again, if we open this up, if we just go to where it says extrude and then just hit enter, we can see the code down here is bpy.context.object.data.extrude equals 0. So select this and copy it. So we can copy this and use this in a second, but we now need to create another if statement. So from here, I'm just going to hit enter. Then I'm going to type if E is equal to true, then add a colon, then we can just paste this in here. We also need a value to change this to, so we need to create another property value. So where it says scale, I'm just going to copy this one since it's a float property. I'm going to use that. Then down here, paste this in, and then make sure we change this name from scale to something else. So I'm going to call this extrude underscore amount. Then we can change this from scale to extrude amount. And the default, let's give this something a lot smaller than one, maybe 0.06, something like that. And again, we need to make sure we reference this. So for this, I'm going to type EA equals self.extrude underscore amount. Then if we go down, instead of this being a number, we're going to change this to EA. And there we go. So again, hit run script, add some text. So you can see it's fairly simple to create our operator and add as many things as we want, things that we find useful that we do a lot. That's pretty much it. We just need to make sure we save this now. And then if you guys want to download this script, I'll make sure to leave a link in the blog so you can go ahead and download that. If you have any suggestions that you want to see implemented into this, or just want to give your thoughts, let us know in the comments below. So I hope this video helped. If it did, be sure to give this video a like. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.